Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, we thanks and praise for guiding, caring and loving us through all the years, through all the days, through all the time. All loving Heavenly Father, I ask you to place the grace of prayer in this auspicious day on the Poumai Naga Tsiidoumai in Delhi, the 30th VEDAOYU NIIH, 23rd September 2017. Oh Lord, I ask you to bless the conquerors and all the people who are going to participate in this program for both sections. Lord, I also continue to pray for those people who are tirelessly work day and night for the smooth function of this program. Lord, continue to bless for their future. Now, Lord, I also pray for our chief guests and guests of honor, for their good health, sound and mind, and for their family. Lord, I also ask to bless all the people who are present here today and who are not able to turn up today. Lord, wherever they are, wherever they stay. As we are living this metropolitan city and we are far away from our hometown, Lord, continue to bless us, continue to protect us from all danger. For this I ask in the name of Jesus. Amen.
In the way, what's the voice of the Redina? Of course, we want him. Ramai, he wanted to have his life. Thank you very much.
This afternoon, we're also privileged to have two other important guests. First, Temjin Inga Along, Chairman and MD, REM Group. He's here with us today, and we are very grateful to you, sir. If you can kindly stand for where you're seated. We would also like to welcome Santapur Singh, Deputy Dean Student Welfare, University of Delhi. So we're grateful to have you here. Moving on next, the people that I'm going to invite on stage now are very, very special. They can win your heart just by being themselves. They shine as they are, and they never fail to delight us and bring the most genuine smiles on our faces. They're here today to present the welcome song. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming the PBCD Sunday School students.
Good afternoon, everyone. PBCD Sunday School Department would like to wish all the freshers a very happy Freshers Day. The title of our song is called Muriers. Hope you enjoy the song.
You might feel in love, you can see the three stairs, where you are. respected Honorable Chief Guest, Shri Conrad Sangma, Honorable Guest of Honor, Shri Sapu Bhattacharya, distinguished guests, representatives from various student bodies, senior members, colleagues, and my dear fellow brothers and sisters. Let me begin by expressing my profound appreciation to our chief guest and guest of honor for accepting our invitation to grace this function. We are also greatly honored and privileged to be surrounded by so many guests and well-wishers. On behalf of the Poumai community in Delhi, I would like to extend a very warm welcome to everyone present here today to the 30th VEDAOYU NIIH 2017. Established 30 years ago in the year 1987 with an objective to promote the culture, education and social economic interests of Poumai Naga here in Delhi. Today we have about 3,500 Poumais living in and around Delhi and NCR. The PNTMD VEDAOYU NIIH is a very important and significant event as it gives us a unique opportunity to showcase our rich cultural heritage through music, arts and culture. It is also a platform to explore and promote young talents. This is the only occasion where all come together once in a year. It is a time and occasion to interact, share wonderful ideas, insights, a time to build unity, promote oneness and brotherhood, and a time of happiness and celebration. And I sincerely believe and hope that the purpose and objective of the event will be fulfilled. On behalf of all the Poumais here in Delhi, I want to also take this opportunity to heartily welcome all the freshers. We assure you that we make you feel at home and will do everything possible to help you achieve your purpose of coming to Delhi. You have all come to the capital of India with a purpose. Delhi is a land of opportunity and all the premier education institution and better jobs opportunities. There are ample of opportunities for those who work hard, but on the other hand, one can easily lose track from the real purpose if we got up in the web without a clarity and purpose of coming here. Therefore, let's all work hard in order to achieve the purpose for which we are here for. We are the ambassador of our community, and I urge everyone to be a good example and role model to the rest of the world. Let us begin our journey together and renew energy and hope with faith, with discipline, with commitment, with persistence, and let us labor and strive and work until we reap the fruit of our labor. Lastly, I would like to extend my heartfelt gratitude to all of you, especially our chief guests and guests of honor, for taking your valuable time to attend our program. Thank you all for making this possible. As we continue with our program, we have many exciting items in store for you. I hope you will take it, sit back and enjoy. Kuk Nalin.
Moving on, we have a small time for presentation. For this, in the first place, I call our honorable chief guest on the stage and receive a small token of gift as a sign of our appreciation.
Prepared for you.
Good morning. On behalf of PTM family, I pay my greetings to all the freshers and also congratulate them and each of them for their success in their board examination, and some of them might have got a new job. And extremely we are happy that you came here to join our family, since we all are members of one family now. Especially the young freshers, you should not hesitate to approach your seniors, anything, whatever. Also, I'm proudly, extremely happy to share that all the seniors and the PNTMD executive members are very helpful and they are very kind. Since I'm given the opportunity to share a few of my experiences to you all, first of all, I begin with being a good mandate. First of all, if you are good mandate, you will learn many things and your mind and your heart will accept many good things in your life. Whether in your studies, whether in your work, and whether in your existence. Second, have patience to learn things. Unless we learn, we will not be able to shine our talent to others. Let us not simply study to pass the examinations, but let us study to learn, because if we learn, we will get tremendous satisfaction in our life. Let us not simply work to get salary, rather let's work to get satisfaction. Let us not look back our past failure and regret. Rather, take our failures as the step of success in days to come. In this world, there does not exist the perfect man or the most successful man. Nevertheless, every human being is subjected to achieve more and more as long as we live in this beautiful world. An individual knows himself the best. God has placed each and every one with different talent, potentials in different ways. What we need to do is we need to identify our potentials. Do not get flattered by others' opinion. Be happy what you are, what we are. Think critically, but do not live critically. Because if we live critically, that may harm me and that may harm others. Always be happy. Try to make others happy. Try to make oneself happy. Because if we are happy, we will see the beauty of life. Respect the dignity of work. Be happy what God has planned for each one of us. Remember, God has sent us to this beautiful world with different purpose. Do not get shattered on others' job, money, wealth, etc. Job, dignity, wealth, money are not the source of happiness, but it is the good knowledge which is the living source of happiness. Enjoy whatever work you do. Enjoy whatever work you do, be your studies or in your work, or the assignment assigned to you by your parents, church, elders, organization, etc. If you enjoy your work, we will not be lazy. Rather, we will start learning many new things. Treat your work as one of your favorite hobbies and do it with a smile. Try to be helpful to others. In return, you will get many helps from others. Be brave. By forgiving others, understanding others, showing our meekness to others. Treat your mainland friends, this word, I mean other than from nowadays, like your friends in your church, organization, and tribe. That is how we can create our good environment in colleges, in workplace, and in our residence. Society is comprised of various individuals. So, in order to build a good society, everyone is responsible. Be farmer, student, super, officers, politician, social and religious leader, etc. Because every one of us is blessed by God with different responsibilities to serve the mankind and to build our society. It is our attitude which decides our fate and destiny. So let us inculcate tirelessly the good attitude. Try to come up with the rapid growing world, because today we have witnessed that the world is tremendously growing in science, technology, economically, socially, religiously, and politically. Now, try to understand and learn the values, importance of democracy, and spread the definition of democracy when you go back home to make aware to those underprivileged people back home. Carry back to your village all the things you have learned from your colleges, university, workplace, your environment. Try to build your society with love and patience. Finally, try to understand the teachings of Jesus Christ and reflect to others with love, because Jesus Christ is the only way, the truth, and the life. Thank you so much. Enjoy your day.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have come to the most anticipated moment of the day. Yes, the introduction of freshers. I request all the freshers seated over there to come and present yourselves to the stage for the self-introduction.
Very good afternoon, everyone. My name is Kakho Thaoli from Poumai. I graduated in the summer day from Shillong, and I've come here for UPSC examination. My big dream is to become an army official with a very firm statement saying there's nothing you can achieve. Thank you.
And good afternoon, everyone. My name is Dawei Das, and I came from Kuwait Relax, and I've passed my 10 plus 3 from around the Moscow College, and I'm pursuing my graduate. And my aim in life is to become a journalist.
Good morning, one and all. My name is Wishu. I'm from Chanakyapuri, Tibangulim. And my designation is as a student. And my aim is just to clear the civil service.
Good afternoon. We are my friend, I am with my boy. I am a good year. He is my village in 11 and 12 Millennium Institute of Sciences in Falun Sudoi. And in June, he died in the morning in Eco Honors Club. I am in life new businessman.
Hello, everyone. My name is Isole, and I'm from Timaikala Village. I'm pursuing my undergraduate in Rastani Village. And my course is BA program. And I really want to become a singer one day. Thank you.
Hi, good afternoon. My name is Prasanne Ramai. I'm from Bhattacharya College. I've completed my graduation from Auditorium College and pursuing my master from Jamia University. My aim in life is to become a good lecturer. Thank you.
Hi, good afternoon, everyone. My name is Shri. I'm from Tungam. My aim in life is to become a business woman. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Joya Sanie. I'm from Tungam Village in Nabe. I'm a graduate and my nursing student. I am in life business.
Hello everyone, my name is Madhavi. I came from Tunga. I did my graduation from Asifu Christian Institute, and my aim in life is to become your hostess. Thank you.
My dear brothers and sisters, my name is Anthony Solana. I'm from Puro. I did my graduation from Sangadev College, Shillong. I'm a student of Vajiram, a coaching institute for UPSC examination. My aim in life is to become a civil servant. Thank you.
Hello everyone. My name is Shri and I'm from Tungam Village. I have finished my BA from around the Moscow College and I have finished my master from Manipur University in Seoul. And currently I am taking stenography coaching. So I'm aspiring to become a stenographer. Thank you.
My name is Izu. I came from Timai Kulin and I passed my 10 plus 2 from Manzai in secondary Sanapati. And right now I'm taking BA History Honor. My aim in life is to become an IS officer. Thank you.
Hello everyone. I am Joy. I'm from Lower Pekung Village. I passed out my 10 plus 2 from Tomosco Higher Secondary School Sanapati. Currently pursuing my BA program first year from Rajshahi College, Raja Garden. And I aspire to become a journalist. Thank you.
Good afternoon, audience. My name is Rasulu Pukumai. I came from Puba village and I passed out my 12th standard from Don Bosco Higher Secondary School, Sanapati. And I'm here for graduation and I'm currently pursuing BA program from Zakir Hussain College. And my aim in life is to become a journalist. Thank you.
Hello, good evening, everyone. My name is Sabha James from Lea Kulen. I did my graduation from KL Bajura, Shillong. My aim in life is to become an army officer.
My name is Conrad from Poumai Village. My hometown and my home place is Sanapati. I'm here today to leave for some extra classes or exams. My aim and target is to become a successful person someday.
Alright, what's up? So I'll show you, hello, I'll show you 30 VEDAOYU NIIH. And I'm ready to tell you, I'm ready to tell you, Yeah, I see you, so we're there. Yeah, our previous college, the insulate, British insulate, the year, Maram DBC, Maram Insulate, I told you, as I'm doing a committee, as I'm doing a prepare, so I will get in life new to become army official.
Je suis venu à ce qui est arrivé à Je suis un grand UN. J'ai tout comme pour l'aide. On a cette année, j'ai prévu school college. Dong School College, but we know history on the senior degree self, right? Yichu coaching center, you can have a favorite. I will in life, you know? Yeah, and then we civil servant, and you say,
good evening, Poumanya. My name is Rakovini from Tungkam Makhi Village, and I did my job from Don Bosco College, Maram, and presently I'm pursuing my graduation. And my aim in life is I'd like to go in an aviation line. Thank you.
Hi, everyone. My name is Amanda. I'm from Goida Village. I did my 10 plus 2 from Mount Zion Senior Secondary School. Currently, I'm working as the front desk manager in Dent I in two of the branches. Thank you.
Hi, good afternoon, one of all. My name is Rainy Grace. I'm from Tungam, TNK Village. I did my 10 plus 2 from Mount Zion Senior Secondary School. My aim in life is to become a designer.
Very good afternoon to one and all. Well, I'm an open engineer from Timbapulan Village. Designation is a student and graduated from Don Bosco College, Maram, Manipur. And purpose of my coming is to crack a competitive exam, and my aim in life is to become a civil servant. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. Nanda Hazar Kanyani Grace Mai. You must be wondering what that means, right? Well, that means what I say is my name is Kanyani Grace Mai. I'm from Kuba Village, and I had my schooling done back in Mysore, Karnataka, southern part of India. And right now, I'm pursuing my graduation in International College for Women. And as for my aim in life, I truly believe I am really interested in diplomacy. I find it really interesting. And if God wills, I believe that I can become a diplomat. Thank you. Have a nice day.
Hello, everyone. I'm really excited to be here today. It's my immense pleasure to introduce myself before Poumai Naga Tsiidoumai immediately. Well, my name is Dr. Dominic from Tsiidoumai Glen. Presently, I'm pursuing graduation. I'm doing my graduation in Atmaram Sanatan Dharma College. I am a student of political science honors. I particularly opted for this political science paper because right after my graduation, I wanted to go for LLB. In the meantime, I'll be writing various exams. And apart from my aim in life, I'm also interested in reading books, watching movies, and of course, spending some quality time with friends. Thank you, and have a pleasant hours ahead.
Good afternoon, one. My name is Albert Dechau. I'm from Rabumai Chima Kulin Village. I did my 10 plus 2 from Nagaland Board of School Education. Presently, I'm pursuing BSc Honor Statistics from Delhi University, and my aim in life is to become a statistician. Thank you.
Hello, beautiful juries. My name is Jay Shaukini Vemai. I'm from Puba Kuman, and I passed off by 12 in Don Bosco Higher Secondary School, Snapdi. And the reason I came here is seeking for a job. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. Talking about my future, my aim in life, the manager of the company, manager listen here. I'm Suzarana, from Kuwait Village. Finished my 10 plus 2 from Kuwait School in Fall. Now pursuing, become honors in Ramses College. My aim in life is to become a businessman.
Good afternoon, everyone. I wish you all a very happy Poumai Naga Tsiidoumai Medal you 30th VEDAOYU. My name is Rosne, I'm from Kuwaiti, and I completed my 12th standard in Maram Don Bosco College. And currently, I'm undergoing 3 months of training in airline, Indigo Airline. Thank you.
My name is Lily Frison from Kuwaiti, now my village. And my aim in life is to become a lecturer. Thank you.
I will show you from. As you know, Sapu, J. Pabunkuno, J.
Don Bosco College Marapuni graduate chilo awiwe je dalhi tri lora dukuli hi triwe awi em life professor thank you
wesu be dalo ni aji a kai boy je a pai mun mai je bicom monograsin chilo tri ai a tri pass le tri
a very good evening to everyone and thank you singer for the for your warm wishes and for your welcome aji hai sekorai mai is a which the way I did my graduation from Bhattacharya Christian College, that is Nagaland, and my aim in life is to become an army officer. Thank you.
Hello everyone, my name is Shavaru. I'm from Kadam Kaba Village. I did my BCom from the Moscow College Maram. Currently, I'm doing banking coaching, and I want to become a bank manager. Thank you.
Hello, good afternoon everyone. My name is Sohia. I'm from Rikulan Village. I did my graduation in Don Bosco College, Maram. I came here to take some exams and my aim in life is to become a bank manager. Thank you.
Hi, good afternoon. My name is Edwin. I'm from Manipur Village. I did my master in history in Manipur, from Manipur University. I came to Delhi to take up some exams and my aim in life is to clear UPSC. Thank you.
Good afternoon, PNTMD. Respected chief guests and guest of honor and everyone in attendance. I am Poumai Naga Tsiidoumai. I'm from Marie Lishan Village and I completed my BBS from Genius and right now I'm working as a registered medical officer in Max Super Specialty Hospital Sakit. And 5 years from now I want to see myself as a surgeon if I continue to remain the same profession. But if fortune favors me, I would like to see myself 5 years from now as a civil servant. Thank you.
Hello, good afternoon everyone. My name is Jesus. I came from Timbakuno Village, Somai. And then I did my BCom, Bachelor of Commerce from Don Bosco College, Maram. And then currently I'm going for coaching, banking in SSC. And my aim in life is to become a bank manager. And thank you. Have a wonderful day.
Good afternoon everyone. My name is J. Kauvi James. I'm from Lakamai Village. And the purpose why I came here is to seek for better opportunities and fulfill the desire of mine. And the previous school of mine is Modern Grace College. Thank you very much.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Sasha Boba, and I'm from Poumai College. I passed my class both from the Moscow High School School Sanapati. And from my end in life, it doesn't matter if I become a doctor or an engineer or anything. If I have a happy life, if I live a happy life, that's enough for me. Thank you.
A very good afternoon to every single one of you who are present here today in this 38th Freshers Meet. My name is Laksan. I'm from Lai Village. I did my graduation last year, that is 2016, from Mount Vista College, Senapati. And my aim in life is to become a musician. Thank you.
Hello. Very good afternoon to everyone present here. I'm here to introduce myself and to tell you about one of the great personality of the century. Well, I'm NS Arbasis from my village. I passed out my degree course from Mount Everest College, Senapati. And currently, I'm preparing for a competitive exam. Then my aim in life is to become a bank official. Thank you.
Hello everyone. My name is Tidio. I'm from Kuwait Village and I passed out my BCom from Monterey College, Sanapati. And my aim in life is to become a good banking officer. And currently I'm preparing for the banking exams. Thank you everyone.
Hello, good afternoon everyone. My name is Dabino Vicky and I come from UK Village, Upper Kuwait Village. So I passed out my graduation last year, that is 2016, in Mount Everest College in Abdi. And I come here to look for a good jobs, to prepare competitive exams. And my aim in life is to become a good father and a successful father of my future children and wife. Thank you all.
Hello, good afternoon. My name is Vini Vissa. I'm from Lai Village. Currently, I'm preparing for competitive examination. My aim in life is to become a good husband. Thank you.
Hello, good afternoon, everyone.
I am Kodiyu from Rokokuba village, presently staying at Meroli. I did my graduation from Dam College of Art. I've come here to achieve my dream of becoming a banker. I love music and playing football. Thank you.
Hello, a very good afternoon to everyone present here. My name is Koshula Justin. I came from Lakhamai village. My aim in life is to create any civil service exam.
A very good morning to everyone. This is Topsung Pao. I'm from Maiwa village. I've done my graduation from Don Bosco College, Maram, with botany as my honors paper. And my aim in life is to become an IFLS officer. Thank you.
Hello, good afternoon, everyone. My name is Dovine. I came from Chiangmai, Timbuktu. I did my graduation from Mount Vista College, DNKS Napati, with economics honors. My aim in life is to become a good housewife.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Roman. I came from DNKS Napati village. I passed my class 12 from Manjain. I came here to pursue my graduation, and my aim in life is to become a salesman.
My name is Raka Nebemai, and I'm from Kubatapam village. I'm doing my BSc first year from IHE college, and my hobby is singing and also my talent. My aim in life is to become a nutritionist.
Hello, PNTMD. Good afternoon. I'm Monai from Pekukulan village, UFMI. I did my graduation from Mount Vista college, and I'm doing my diploma. And I aspire to become a journalist in the future. Thank you.
Hi, good afternoon, everyone present here. I'm Raghuvane from Koide village, and I did my 10 plus 2 from Don Bosco Higher Secondary School, Tenanti. And I'm here for seeking a job. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Topo Olympus. I'm presently pursuing my BA program from Tsukhi Rusan, and my aim in life is to live a happy and contented life. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. I'm Jinu Kaboi, Jipan Glen, I'm a class of Kuching Pasalui, Heritage Christian College, Manipuram Pasalui. She tells the tree how doesn't tree, she should learn the tree by. That learn the tree, the one who is children, Bachelor of Fine Art, the way, Mother Nagarna. They are with him, after him, life, that's the way, great artist, the same way. The one who is fine art, the way, truly there.
Hello, everyone. My name is Daphne. I'm from Bhuba village. I did my graduation from Mount Press College, and presently I'm preparing for the competitive examinations, and my aim in life is to become a great officer. Thank you.
I'm Namne from Koide village. I did my 10 plus 2 from Don Bosco College, Maram, Manipur, and my purpose of coming for the Delhi was to continue my father's studies, and my aim in life is to become a bank manager. Thank you.
Hi everyone, good afternoon. My name is Kinan Dismumai. I'm from Timbuktu village. I passed my 10 plus 2 from Madhyam Senior Secondary School, and currently I'm studying at Madhuri College, Botany first year. Thank you.
Hi, good afternoon to all. My name is Jovane Poumai. I belong to Pouba village. I completed my pre-university from Don Bosco School, Senapti. I have come here to make my career in aviation industry. To be specific, I want to be a cabin crew. My hobbies are dancing, cooking. I love to experiment cooking new food. I also love to rap. My favorite rapper is Nicki Minaj. That's all. Have a good day.
Respective guests of honor, dignitaries, seniors, and all my fellow fresher friends. It is a special privilege for me to stand here today in front of you all. Poumai Naga Tsiidoumai Me Delhi, VEDAOYU NIIH is one of the most awaited events of Poumai Naga in Delhi. It is here today, so let's make the best use of this special day and enjoy every bit of it. I stand here today bearing the perspective and thoughts of all the Poumai fresher in Delhi this year. And on their behalf, I want to say a sincere thank you for organizing this special occasion of welcoming us to the family of Poumai Delhi. Being away from home, still trying to get adapted in this new environment, among new people, we are missing home so dearly. terribly. But today, seeing all of you, our people gathered, a microcosm of Poumai Naga is a very relieving and delightful kind of sentiment. Some of us have come here in pursuit of academic studies, some seeking job, but all of us have a common interest, that is to make our careers, to pursue our dreams and to achieve our goals. Dear seniors, I want to acknowledge that you are the pivotal reason because of whom we being here in Delhi is possible. You not only paved the way and made a room for us to create our future from here, but because of your presence in this place, our parents, without any hesitation and apprehension, have seen us here because they believe and we believe that you are there to care and guide us through. Venturing into a new world, into an exciting and decisive phase of life, we are so full of enthusiasm and expectations. We are so full of dream and spirit. We know the city and the life ahead have so much to offer, but we are naive, inexperienced, and vulnerable. So we need a constant guidance and instructions, maybe academic, career, and professional, or even moral or emotional guidance. We always need you. So please pamper us, rebuke us in our wrongdoing, direct us, encourage us, and lead us the right way. We look up to you. From what I have heard, Poumai Naga in Delhi are very helpful and supportive, especially our student leaders and elders are very quick to help, especially in times of need and adversity. This is a great virtue you have to applaud yourself for, a strain that we must always keep up. Dear fellow freshers, let the burning spirit and enthusiasm we come here along with not vanish into thin air with time. But let us give our base in things we do and make our adventure purposeful and worthwhile. Also, let us continue to love and support PNTMD and render our contributions to it in any form whenever it needs us. Lastly but not least, the motto of PNTMD says liberation through education. I believe that the concept of education is not just about a learning process that takes place within a classroom, but in every walk of life, the new experience, the new knowledge and enlightenment we acquire is a kind of education. So may our new learning, our broader horizon liberate us from the psychological or cultural forces that are caging us towards the limitless horizon. May we always soar higher to glorify our Almighty, for the welfare of our society, for our smile on our parents' face, and our individual moral satisfaction. Thank you, PNTMD.
As we pray for the freshers, I would like to leave a scripture passage for them. The scripture passage is very common. It is a Sunday school Bible verse. Proverbs 1:7 says, "The fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge, but fools despise wisdom and instructions." Let us all unite our hearts together and pray for the freshers. God of Almighty and Everlasting Father, God of wisdom and knowledge, you are awesome, you are wonderful, you are our creator, and we are your creatures. When we think of your love and blessings, we are amazed and we are so blessed. We are so much thankful unto you for the way you have loved us. And we particularly give thanks unto you at this very moment for the lives of these young men and women who are standing here. You have brought them here into this big city with different visions, dreams and purposes in their life. You have created them so beautifully. You have given them purposes in their lives. And they want to pursue this. As they have come to create their future, to find their life's purpose and goal from here, help them decide the right career. Give them the insight to choose the purpose you have for them. In whatever field it may be in an academy, professional, or any kind of work that they are looking for, they are entering into the decisive stage of their life. The subject, career, and the line of work they now choose is crucial to their future. It is a humble prayer that you will reveal to them your purposes in their lives. Guide them, inspire them, so that through your intervention, they can rely on you and choose the right purpose and achieve their goal. Secondly, we want to pray for their safety here, their physical well-being here. Lord, as they continue to stay here, the concern of getting used to a new surrounding and atmosphere is a matter of challenge for many as they come into a new place. I beseech your blessing upon these young people to be able to adapt well in this new environment, both mentally and physically. Give them good health, fit enough to withstand against all possible sicknesses and unseen life attacks. Protect them from any possible dangers and accidents. I also pray for their spiritual life. They are away from home, and there are many young people who doesn't know how to rely on you, who doesn't know how to build relationship with you. Being away from home, being away from their near and dear ones, they take it as granted. Lord, it is a humble prayer that you will inspire these people and remind them that the fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge. Let this be their life's motto as they pursue their studies, their career, their professions, and whatever work they are in. May this place be a place where they develop in different areas of lives and go back with lots of achievements, and their achievement, their lives will be able to glorify you. As they are here to this place, may you come and bless them, take care of them, so that Jesus, their life will be a channel of blessing to themselves, to the family, to the society, and to the world. And that is how the world can be changed, through their small beginning and small contribution, committing their lives, their career, their professions into your loving care. With thanksgiving, we pray this in Christ's blessed name. Amen.
Poumai Naga tribe is one of the oldest and largest tribe among the Nagas. The Poumai Naga country is geographically located in Manipur as well as in Nagaland. In Manipur, we are predominantly inhabiting the district of Chanakyapuri, and in Nagaland, we inhabit in Fake district. The people of Poumai Naga speak in a dialect called Pola. Poumais are well known for their bright and colorful traditional attires and costumes with wonderful designs, as we can see in the slide. Their accessories are also considered as one of the best among the Nagas of Southern Nagaland. The word Poumai is derived from two syllables, which is Po and Mai. Po here is the progenitor of Poumai people, and Mai is the descendants of Po. In other words, Po is the name of the ancestor, and his descendants are known as Poumai. The Poumai Naga tribe was recognized officially as a tribe by the central government of India in the year 2003 under the Constitution of Scheduled Caste and Scheduled Tribe Amendment Act of 2002. The Poumai Naga country covers an area of approximately 1,200 square kilometers, and geographical area of which they occupy is 93 degree 47 minute east, 94 degree 18 minute east in longitude, and 25 degree 10 minute north, and 25 degree 31 minute north with an altitude of 1,061 to 1,788 meters above the sea level. The Poumai Naga tribe is divided into three circles in Manipur and one in Nagaland, namely Lepauna, Paumata, and Chilewai, which are in Manipur, and the Razaba circle, which is in Nagaland. Together, these four circles makes up the Poumai Naga tribe. The Poumai Naga tribe is a major Naga tribe with a population of 1,89,189 as per the 2011 census, with 1,79,189 people living in Chanakyapuri district, Manipur, and 10,000 living in Fek district in Nagaland. There are presently 94 Poumai inhabited villages, out of which 85 are revenue recognized villages and 9 which are unrecognized. Out of these 94 villages, 4 villages are in Fek district of Nagaland. It may be noted that we also have a standing MLA in the government of Nagaland. The Poumai Naga tribe is considered an important tribe in Manipur and Nagaland since time immemorial. Here we can see some pictures of Poumai villages. Here we see the Barak River, which has its home in Poumai Naga country, traces its origin back to Liai village, which is also the biggest village among the Poumai villages. Here is, we see Namaijo, which is another very scenic landscape of Poumai land. The Poumai Naga tribe are also known for their pottery, the artun pottery, and also the pote, the po salt, locally produced salt. These items are very well known among the entire tribal areas in Manipur and Nagaland. Here we see the making of rice barn. Poumai people are also skilled in handicrafts. Here we see examples of handicrafts by Poumai beads and other items. The craftsmanship of Poumai people is also seen in the houses which they build. Here are seen Tona, Pauna, and Launa. These are the three major festivals which are celebrated among all the Poumai villages. Tona festival is an occasion of thanksgiving to our deity for good harvest and good health. The Pauki, the transplantation festival, is celebrated to invoke gods for healthy crops, protection from natural disasters, good monsoon, and bountiful harvest. Longna is a traditional festival that marks the end of paddy transplantation for the year. People thank God for a successful transplantation. During the festival, different sports like wrestling, tug of war, and pole climbing, etc. are played. Today we have Poumai residing all around the country, and presently in Delhi, we have a strength of around 3,000 Poumai people living in the city. Thank you.
inviting me on this 30th anniversary of the Poumai Naga Tsiidoumai in Delhi. And it is a pleasure to be here as the guest of honor along with our chief guest, Mr. Conrad, Sangma. Conrad Sangma, as we say, he is not a member of parliament. Yes, he is a member of parliament from Garo's parliament. But to us, his interest for the entire Northeast and the entire Northeast of people as such, and the love of his irrespective of any tribe or any communities of the Northeast, we feel that he is a member of parliament for the entire Northeast. As I know, now for so many years, more than 20 years or so, I have been associated with that parliament. And I live almost 40 to 50% of my time in Nagaland, in Poima, Omro, Mon. And as I know of the Poumai tribe, Poumai is a Denimia tribe where with much similarities between the Angamis and the Pochuri. Now, it is also good to know that Poumai community amongst all the Naga tribes in Delhi is the biggest. For me, I look this thing, the Naga exodus, I feel it is still continuing. And as I look at it, that more people outside of their own homeland in search of education, in search of jobs, in search of opportunities, is because these are not available. I'm very sorry to say that these are not available in our areas. Today's day, we may take pride that we are the best. Of course, we are the best. But we have to also create our own opportunities. And we cannot expect somebody from elsewhere will come in and give us that opportunity on a platter. So, as far as the Northeast is concerned, we feel that our weaknesses is to be converted as our strength. You see, today's day, it is very sad to say, during our childhood time, we had one of the best education center, that was Shillong. We had the St. Peter's, the St. Anthony's, St. Edmund's, St. Mary's, Loreto, and they were the best of the institutions, throughout the country. During our time, people used to come and study, even from outside of India. We had the best of faculties, we had the best of everything, and then that's it. Today's then, we don't get opportunities, our children, we don't get opportunities to become a doctor because we do not have enough medical colleges. Our children cannot become engineers, seats are limited because we do not have engineering institutes. This is something which is, and today's day, we, like our children come, of course, we can go anywhere, wherever we want to. This is our country, This is our world. But, you know, we look for better opportunities. Also, migration is, of course, also a process of life, process of human being, which cannot be stopped. But because there is no opportunities available in our areas, there are people coming to mainland India. Is a very sad situation. I would also like to bring into one, to your difficulties. Like for after implementation of the GST. Now, we are a part of India. After implementation of the GST, people of Northeast, for the people of Northeast, the GST applies at 10%, or at, 10 lakhs. Whereas for mainland India and the rest of India, GST starts to apply after 20 lakhs. So, are we a different economic zone? If so, then it should be defined these matters at the right platform. Of course, this is not the platform, at the right platform should be taken up by our leaders, that either we evolve into a different economic zone, or if we are at par, then the development issues should be at par compared with any other states in the rest of India. Now, this space of this business has to be created by us ourselves. Today's day, look at the business communities. Of course, now when I first got into business, our people from my parents, then my relatives used to say that why you are not becoming an engineer, why not an IAS officer, or why not a doctor, how come you have gone into business? Today's day, outlooks have changed. A lot of our people have entered into business. And we must emphasize that the economy of our land should not be handed over to anybody else, but it should remain in our own hands. If we have the economy in our hand, we have everything. So we have to look for studies elsewhere. We have to do everything elsewhere. After that, we must analyze what is there and what is not there. With all this wisdom that we gather, we should go back to our homeland and try to create a better land where everybody else wants to go and then settle there, than we coming elsewhere and then settling elsewhere. And the people who can afford are looking for opportunities elsewhere. And if this continues in the next 50 to 100 years, we will lose our originalities. So the responsibility, like I said, that today we have our honorable member of parliament and present with us who's from the parties. So this process remains in our hands. We are the voters. We should select good people, committed people. We should not sell our votes. We should not sell our rights we should send good, learned, committed people at the right platform so that these opportunities can be created for us. Of course, politics always depends in case of numbers, but we should look away where our weakness can be converted into our strength. Today's day, we don't have a road in Bangalore. Maybe also in the southern part of Bangalore. We don't have bridges, we don't have hospitals, we don't have schools, we don't have colleges. Enough so that all our children can be accommodated. And with this, the people who can afford are sending their children to rest of India or anywhere else. So which means 80% of the education budget we spend within our lifetime is spent outside of our area. Similarly for healthcare, we are spending lakhs and lakhs of rupees, not in our place. Our economy is being drained out from that region, and in the times to come, we'll be left with nothing. We will be only patients, we'll have no doctors, we'll have no development. So, today's day, whatever we can do, we must bring in good education institutions to our area. We should bring in good hospital healthcare in our area. We should develop tourism in our areas. We should develop, these are all industries that one should have. We should pave way for anybody, or it should become a policy decision for us to bring in such an investment in the entire countries. As our friend had already introduced, the Poumai area, having 199,000 plus populations spread in Manipur and as well as in Nagaland, he said that the Poumai are good agriculture, he is very colorful, dress, this, that. But he forgot to say that Poumai people are also known for their wisdom. So we hope good wisdom prevails with us, and I pray, Lord, to give blessing to us and the Poumai as a whole. Thank you.
A very good afternoon to everyone. I'm very happy and very glad to be here today to be part of the 30th VEDAOYU NIIH program festival that we're having today, organized by the Poumai Naga Tsiidoumai in Delhi. Our dear guest of honor and a dear friend of mine, Mr. Sabu, our other guest of honor, Mr. Along, our president, secretary, and organizing committee members, all the senior students and senior citizens of the Poumai tribe staying in Delhi, and most importantly, my dear students and freshers who have come here today, this is your day. In the beginning, when the introduction was going on, I was telling Sapu, I had a bet with him. So I was telling him, the next person is going to say that my aim in life is to be a politician, just watch. And then it didn't happen. Then I said, now you watch, the next one is going to say that my aim in life is to be a politician. And it didn't happen again. In fact, when we counted at the end, nobody wanted to be a politician. So So actually I was telling Sapu, I think I should leave. Because maybe people are looking at me and they're feeling so discouraged about politicians that nobody wants to be a politician. It's quite sad, actually, to see that our politicians have failed to inspire the younger generation. But it's really nice to see that you are so focused in your mind and in your hearts on what you want to do in life. I really, really admire that about each and every one of you. And the confidence that you had when you spoke about what you wanted to do was really amazing. I remember myself, those college days, and if somebody told me to come on stage and talk, my God, I would be trembling and shaking. But then you were so confident and so casual and so focused on what you wanted to do. It was wonderful. I really admire that, and I congratulate each and every one of you. You know, when you talked about the goals in your life and what you wanted to be, a story was coming in my mind. I think some of you heard it, but most of you might not have heard it. It's about two teams, you know, playing football. And then after playing for 2 hours or 3 hours, the match ended. And the score was 0-0. And you know why the score was 0-0? The score was 0-0 because they were playing without goalpost. So it was a football match where they kept kicking the ball and there was no goalpost. That is how important the goal is in life. Because without a goalpost, you will continue kicking the ball in your life and you continue working and continue moving in life without being able to reach anywhere. So it is important to have a goal in life. Then you know what you're doing and what you're working towards. And that goalpost might shift tomorrow. You want to be a bank manager today, tomorrow you just may want to be a politician. You want to be in the aviation sector, you may tomorrow start your own business. But having a goal in life is so critical to make sure that you're moving in the right direction. Delhi is a difficult place, let me tell you. I grew up in Delhi. I studied in Delhi. My father was a member of parliament. And because of the people's love for him, he was a member of parliament for 30 years. And we got a chance to study in Delhi. And I can tell you, Delhi can be a very difficult place. Yes, a lot of opportunities, but at the same time, a lot of challenges too. I want to tell the youth that is coming in here today, I was so inspired when I heard the prayer that was offered by one of the reverends. I'm sorry, I'm forgetting your name. But when he mentioned about the different distractions in life, it's very true. Delhi will have the maximum of that. More importantly, this is not Northeast. So you'll have different kind of people, different kind of culture, different kind of lifestyle, which really might not match with yours. No. I was studying in Delhi till class 6. Then I went in my class 6 to Shillong to study in St. Edmund's School for 3 years. I was there. That time I was a Delhiite, literally. My entire action, my talking style was like, you know, a North Indian Delhi person would be. And suddenly I went to Shillong and I tried to be a smart Delhi fellow. Only to realize that Northeast people don't talk much, they just hit directly. So I picked up a fight with one small fellow from Arunachal Pradesh. And before I could say anything to him, his fist came flying in my face. And I was flat on the ground for about 2-3 minutes. I know that's the difference in the way we are. And I'm not saying you have to change the way you are. Please don't change. Always be what you are, always be comfortable with what you are. Always believe in what you are. But then we have to live in an environment. Let's be aware of the environment, that's all. Just be careful for yourself. There's no harm in being careful. there's no harm in keeping a watch. So I'm not here to discourage you or make you feel scared that Delhi is a bad place. It's not. It's a great place. It's a great place. I grew up in Delhi. I like Delhi a lot. Yes, there are some difficult people, but that's okay. That doesn't represent the general crowd. But as I said, be careful for yourself. Delhi can be a challenging place. I think all of you are very lucky, let me tell you. I think what Mr. Sapu was mentioning is very relevant. That maybe just about 10% of us get this opportunity to be here and come to Delhi. 90% of us don't get this opportunity. Your parents have been very kind to you. The love that they've shown to you, I hope you respect that love. I hope you respect the contribution that your parents are making for you and how hard they've worked to ensure that you are here today. The sweat they've put in, the hard work, the money, I hope you respect that. And always keep it in mind, whenever and whatever you're doing, that it is because of your parents that you are here. We tend to forget it sometimes, you know, youngsters. You know, that's how I was in college and I got an opportunity to study in the States. And, you know, we get so engrossed in what we do that we don't realize that what our parents go through. Till you become a parent, you know, and then you realize, you know, how you have to bring up your children. So always remember your parents. And I would always tell you, and I really agree with what is in the Bible and what our Reverend has said, that knowledge starts with the fear of the Lord. Always keep that in mind. No matter what you do in life, my father used to always tell me that, Conrad, you want to be in politics? You have to remember three things. First, never run after position. Don't want to be an MLA or an MP. That is not the purpose of being in politics. If you are going to be in politics, make sure that you're there to change people's lives. Make sure you're there with the intention of helping people. If you're there with the intention of wanting to be an MP or a minister or an MLA, then you're already losing before you're starting. Second, he told me, don't be after money. Because then again, if you're after money, your entire purpose of being in politics is gone. Yes, politics requires money, but that should not be your goal in life. Your goal should be to help people. Your goal should be to be clean. The system will follow. You will get position. People will love you. And if you help them, people will support you. And third most important thing he told me was always, always depend on God on any situation. I've been in politics for a very long time. I don't look very young. Of course, I'm slightly younger compared to other politicians. I know I look old, but compared to them, I'm younger. But I've been in politics since I was 12 years old. I started campaigning for my father at the time. I joined the youth of my party. I climbed the walls, I climbed the trees, I stuck posters. I did everything that the youth party does for the party. I contested election and I thought I was P.S. Sangma's son, so I will win. And lo and behold, I lost my first election. And that loss taught me so many things in life. Taught me my first lessons in politics. That connecting with the people is so important. So life has been like that. Comparatively, as I said, I've been in politics for almost 20 years now, contested 4 elections. Lost 2 elections and won 2 elections. So it's always like that. And every time I had difficulty, I can tell you, I always remembered the 3-4 things that my father taught me. He's not here in this world anymore, but those points keep ringing in my mind. So I will tell you that always, always fear the Lord and depend on the Lord. I am talking through my own experience in life. You might think that I'm, just talking because I have to talk. No, I'm not. I'm really sharing my heart with you and my thoughts with you. Because I love, talking to the youth. I was so lucky, day before yesterday I was in Mizoram. I interacted with 900 students from the Mizoram University, and we're talking about youth and politics. I was so excited, you know, to talk to them about entrepreneurship, which Sapu just talked about. You know, and what he's saying is absolutely true. And that's my last point. I know you're all getting tired of the lectures, but politicians can talk. That's my last point to you. I know you all have come here to put up and bring up your careers in life. It's absolutely right. That's what anybody would do. But when you do get a chance in life, and I know God will give you a chance because all of you are very young, bright students and bright minds who really want to make a difference in their lives, in their lives, in their family. But when you get a chance in life in the future, try to give back something to your own people. I think it's very critical. I keep telling everywhere I go, in any program which is to do with Northeast, especially the younger generation, is that if Northeast ever has to change, it has to be the young minds. And the only way for the young minds to change is through entrepreneurship. I was so happy to hear so many young girls and young boys say that I want to start my own business. Start. I can tell you, I'm an entrepreneur myself, but I can tell you the risks you can take in life right now, maybe 10 years later you can't. And when I say risks, those doesn't mean bad risks. Don't think I'm telling bad things. I'm talking about good risks, calculated risks. Let me try starting a business. You can afford to do it now, not after 10 years, not after 15 years, because then age won't be with you. You'll have family, you'll have children. You start to get a bit, you know, careful in life. But this is the chance to start. And don't, you know, I'm sorry, Sapu might disagree with me, but let me tell you, I've always believed that if we keep complaining about the difficulties and challenges, then it will never end. Yes, there are no roads in Northeast, so what? Yes, we have got militancy problem, so what? Yes, we have got power problem, so what? Should that stop the young minds to take the initiative? That is my challenge to you. Because otherwise tomorrow we will get the road and you will say, oh well, there's no power. Then the power will come, you will say, well, there is no human resource. Then human resource will come and then you say, well, there is no market. It goes on and on and on. That is life. That is Northeast. That is India right now. So take that challenge, make a start, say that I will do it, I will take a challenge. So I would like you, the young minds, to think in that line. So without taking more time, I thank the students' body that has very graciously called me to be here. I came specially for this program, let me tell you. I've been traveling like crazy, and I was in Mizoram yesterday, and I have got a program in my constituency. So I reached last night at 8 o'clock and I'm leaving now after this program for my constancy. So I have come just for this program because I was told, you know, the youth will be there. I said that, well, I'll change my program and I'll come just for this one day. So I'm here specially to meet you, specially to share my thoughts with you, and specially to tell you that you are special. And I think the entire Northeast, the young generation really can contribute a lot to us. Society. Yes, follow your path, follow your career, take the opportunity that is available in the cities, learn what you can, and when you get the chance in life, and I'm sure you will, try to give back something to your own people. And I would love it if I would see young generation people coming up and starting business in Northeast. I think that's really the core issue today, and entrepreneurship is the way forward for us. So with these few words, I once again welcome all the students. I wish and I pray for your success in life, that Almighty may really guide you, may protect you, may bless you and your entire family, not just the new students, all the senior students also, and all the people from the Poumai tribe who are staying here in Delhi and from Northeast. I wish each and every one of you the very best for the future. Thank you very much. Jai.
First of all, I would like to thank God for this great opportunity that is blessed upon me to be here with my fellow friends. most respected chief guest of this event, Shri Conrad K. Sangma, Member of Parliament. The guest of honor, my uncle, because he has married a Naga lady, Sapu, Bhattacharya. Eminent and distinguished educationists who are here, and my brothers and sisters of Poumai students here in Delhi. First of all, I'd like to congratulate the Poumai Naga Tsiidoumai Delhi for hosting such a wonderful event. I belong to our tribe, and I am a Naga. And I am proud of the Poumais of Naga tribe. My dear brothers and sisters, the time is now, and I will not take much time to speak with you a few words. As I stand here on the dais today, I, as a fellow Naga, reach out my heart to you all who are sitting here. In a time when India, this great country, is going through a change, a system which is being renovated, renewed, and it is being thrust upon us, we Nagas, and the notice people in general. My dear brothers and sisters, you are 3,000 of you, you say, and we Nagas here would be approximately around 20 to 30,000 here in Delhi. I am not here to give you a political speech. I am here to ask you to lean your hearts and your minds towards this great country. And not forget from where you belong. You are a proud Naga, blessed to be in this great city of Delhi. And I tell you, my dear friends, we are contagious people. Am I correct? We are contagious people. And we may be little, we may be small, we may have difficult times, we may come from small villages, from backgrounds where people may laugh at us because of our fooding habits or so-called of our different ways of living. But we are people who are different. We are those people that really bring the spice to this country. Today, lean your ears to me. I too am young, like you are young. Lean your hearts not to the background from where you have belonged, not to the poverty that you, from where you have come. And I am sure many of you who are sitting here, my heart goes out again and again to you, for you must have come from a farming background, for you must have come from a village background, for you must have come from a background that is poor and difficult to even meet the daily needs of our family. But we, being a proud people, have sent you here. Our parents, being proud, have sent you here to be at the realms where the topmost of this country is studying. And it is for you to keep your hearts and your mind, to have that endeavor alive till the very end of our days. Today, I am proud to speak to my fellow people. Today, when I was watching the video here, I really felt something in my heart. And my dear fellow friends, the first encounter with a Poumai man in my life was when I was young, in my class 9 in the Moscow school, Dimapur. And he was in UG. He was an underground man. He was a good man, a good friend of mine. Today I have come to know that Poumais are one of the biggest tribes among the Nagas. And now I want you to know one thing, that many of us who are living here in Delhi, especially Nagas, maybe Poumais, Maos, Zelian, Ao, Sema, Lotas, there is a lot of things that we still need to accomplish. An accomplishment not only in our education, but also accomplishment to know each other. The differences and the problems today that are arising in Nagaland and in the rest of the Naga inhabited areas is because have not known each other. When I see my people dancing here, I feel proud. I am like that. When I see my villages of Poumai people there on the street, I am proud for my people lives like that. When I see that you look like me and I look like you, and we might eat similar foods, and we dream and we aspire for a united people, and I know why we are dreaming that today. I am proud to say that, not belittled. My dear friends, I wish and we meet again and again. Today, I would just like to conclude my speech by saying, in the dreams that you are going through, in the dreams that you have come here to achieve, especially the freshers, and in the leaders that are already established here, if you have come with a sparkle in your eyes, do not lose that sparkle till the end of your days. If you have lost your sparkle who are there here, kindly renew it. Be contagious. Let the rest of the country know that we people of Northeast and Nagas in particular have arrived. Let them know and not define us by the way we look in our eyes or by the food that we eat. Let them look at us and know that these are our people and these are the people that makes this India proud. Thank you very much. May God bless all of you. Jai Hind.
Gathering warmer. Thank you so much for coming.
I also take this time to thank the leaders and invitees from various tribes and student bodies for your presence in today's program and accepting our invitation. Thank you for coming. We would also like to express our gratitude to the Executive Council 2017-18 Advisory Board and Organizing Committee. I believe until we truly walk in other people's shoes, we fail to understand the sacrifice they had to make. The wheels have started rolling months ago. While we enjoy the food, the music, the talk, the crowd, and the activities in the event today, it is because of the immense dedication and hard work. We will not be able to repay you for all the efforts and the many sleepless nights, but our smile with gratitude is the only reward and the confirmation that we enjoy the event. Thank you. Moving forward, I would also like to express our heartfelt thanks to the various program partakers, the panel of judges, the receptionists, registrars, volunteers, and transportation in charges, sound in charges, stage setting and lighting, press and media, catering, and all the people who worked behind the scene for making today's program a resounding success. I sincerely want to thank our contributors and donors, seniors and well-wishers for the love and support that has been given to us. Where we stand today is a combination of all your endeavors and efforts, and we know that we can go forward with renewed confidence that you will all be there to celebrate our victories and lift up us in our falls. Thank you so much for generously donating for this very big event. Finally, dear members, we are overjoyed that you made it to this event. It is wonderful to see you all, and we really appreciate you coming here to be with us. Thank you for being part of this special event. It means a lot to us. To conclude, let me once again reiterate that without you all, we will never have the courage to dream and the passion to make it happen. So thank you all.
Show. Sure.
We pray together. Let's pray.
Our Father, we thank Thee for all the success and also helping us to learn from our failure. Lord, our comforter, our counselor, our encourager, our friend, and our teacher. You are always there to protect us when we are alone and afraid. You are always there to share our excitement and our worries. You build our confidence and our vision. You help us to learn and gain wisdom. Lord, your love and blessing are uncountable. Lord, we also thank you for our students' leader, for our organizer committee, for bringing us into this various and blessing day to encourage one another, to love one another, to respect one another, and to show concern one another. Lord, we pray for the freshers, for the old-timers, may your good care be with us and fulfill our aims in life. And Lord, we also thank for all the partakers in this program. May you continue to bless them. And Lord, most of all, we thank you for your presence in our program. Lord, may your goodness and love continue to lead us. For all these things, we pray in the glorious name of Jesus. Amen.